folks, welcome to another episode of Matteo's Travel. I'm Matteo and today I'm in a hotel room. Yes, because the hostel is quite empty, they decided to give me a whole room instead. So I have a nice double bed and actually the room looks quite nice here, I must say. So really enjoy my time here. I'm actually in Yazd, but the video is about Shiraz, so let's just pretend I'm in Shiraz and talk about it. So Shiraz, it's also quite in the southwest of Iran, and this city is quite special for several things, like you have the tomb of Hafez or Hafiz, you have Persepolis there. And you have the Pink Mosque. Like those three things are the main attractions there. All in all, Shiraz is quite on a plateau, surrounded with mountains. And I was there in January. It was quite cold and the city is not made for the cold. So the hostels and where I went to were really open spaced. Like even like the bathrooms, there was no door. It was just like outside everything. So they are quite used to the heat. So for summer, it's perfect. But for the winter, it's freezing cold. So I cannot recommend it for the winter. I think for the winter it's better to get a nice hotel room instead of a hostel, because the hostels, they're really not made for it. But who goes to Iran in January anyway? But so far, Shiraz is also quite a small and nice town. I'm not sure if I can call it city because it's really quite small, like the city center is not that big. You have like a big huge castle in the middle. Beside the castle you have some very nice cafes. I also bought some very nice shoes there. Like these are the shoes I bought there. They are knitted shoes. So they look like this. You have them in a lot of different colors. Just gonna show you to you. It's quite nice. They are completely vegan, just by the way, and also quite comfortable. And the best thing is, they're brilliant for traveling because you can just like smash them together and they're like this. It's brilliant, I love them. So these shoes are very traditional in Iran and you can also find them in other places. So far I saw them in Tehran, in Shiraz and in Yazd. But I'm sure if you look close enough, you will find them in other cities for sure as well. But anyway, in Shiraz as well, there are several mosques. The most famous one is the Pink Mosque. You definitely heard of it because of the rainbow colors it gets inside. So, the thing with the mosque is, the pictures you see, they are true. But the thing is, it's a very small room. Like, I think it was one of the smallest mosques I've seen in Iran. So it's really like a big hall, just one of the halls. Because in Iran, you have to know most of the mosques, they are like quarters. The inside is like usually like outside and you have like the mosque around, like built around. And just this one part of the mosque is actually the prayer hall. So it's very small. So you don't have a lot of space there. And as well, it's only for a certain time. So in the winter time, it's starting around 7:30 to 10 a.m. Before 7:30, the sun is too low, and after 10 a.m. the sun is too high, so the light is not going in the mosque anymore. So you don't have those beautiful light reflections anymore. I also would suggest go in the early morning because it's so small, like after 1 or 2 hours, like actually around 8:30 p.m. there were like 20-25 people in the mosque. It was already too much. Like you couldn't get nice pictures anymore. It was just too many people already. So keep that in mind when you want to visit this mosque. Go as early as possible and expect a small place. But the pictures are beautiful. Like here is a selfie of me. Like I love it. And I was able to catch an empty space and just look at the brilliant colors. It's really, really magical. So it's worth visiting, but stand up early. And then as well, there is like the tomb of Hafez. It's like a very, very famous poet in Iran. Everybody knows about him. There is also like a book with all of his poems. The interesting thing is like they have like a special tradition here. Like you have to think about something you want to have an answer to while you have the book. Then you just open the book randomly and you read what's written there and think about it. And this page is helping you to find the answer or the instructions you need. It's quite nice. And the tomb itself, it's actually quite small. I also find it a bit overpriced for tours because there's not much information given. If you are a fan of Hufvud, it's definitely worth visiting. Otherwise, you can see the tomb from the outside already because it's just a pavilion basically. So when you stand from the outside, you can already see the pavilion. So you don't need to go inside if you're not a huge fan of him. And as well in Shiraz, you can go on a day tour to Persepolis. Persepolis is like a very ancient Persian town. Well, I wouldn't say town anymore because the town part is completely gone. It's just like the palace and temple and everything that's still there. It's on a plateau above the town. From the town, you really see nearly nothing anymore. And it got destroyed by Alexander the Great. He burned it down, unfortunately. And there's still a lot to see there, actually. Like when you go there, you have the big plateau. You can go up, you see the entrance gate still. You can go around, you see the treasury where it was. They rebuilt the harem, but with the harem, you have to pay extra. It's the exact same fee as the entrance fee to go in. I didn't go in. If you really want to go in, be aware of that. But otherwise, Persepolis is really nice without the harem too, so you don't need to go in. Also, you see a lot of the palace walls still there. There are also like two tombs you can visit on the other side. They are in or like on the mountain wall. They're quite nice. You also see like this angel-like figure there, which is really interesting to see. And it takes around 3 to 4 hours to see it all, and it's very, very interesting. Like all the statues you see, you still see the reliefs and everything on the walls. It's quite nice. It's an interesting town to see, definitely. And as well, from there, you can go to the necropolis. Necropolis, it's basically just like a cliff, and on the cliff, there are like four tombs. They look exactly the same like the tombs you saw in Persepolis. And you have to pay the exact same price as for Persepolis. So, honestly, there is nothing to see because you're not allowed to go into them. You can just stand from the outside and take photos of it. And honestly, you can just like go to the gate and look through the gate to it and save the money. Like, it's the same thing. So, I didn't understand why they had to charge you so much. So, really. Go there, go to the gate, see it from the gate, and that's it. Don't go in. But it's still quite interesting to see. Like when you imagine how old it is and they created something like that on the cliffs, it's quite impressive. It's similar to Petra, I would say, in a sort of way. Yes. And like there, I was even with a group that, like with 3 friends I found in Tabriz and Tehran. We also had like our last evening there, which was very, very special to us. So we went to a traditional Iranian restaurant, which was really nice. It was a buffet we were able to eat, and we had a hookah there, which was really good. And they had some live music, which was even better. So we had a really enjoyable evening. And there is a little video about it, so have fun with it. As you can see, it was really an interesting evening. I really quite enjoyed it. The interesting thing was, it was also really cheap. Like, we ate a lot, we drank a lot, we had the hookah and everything. And we paid like 7 euro per person. It was like nothing. Like, it's a touristic thing, yes. So I expected actually more, but it was still very cheap. So yeah, Yuan is cheap. It's incredible. And all in all, Shiraz, I really quite enjoyed. It's small, it's walkable, it's nice to go around. It's really, really nice. The people are very friendly there. I can really recommend you to see it. Yes, so I hope you enjoyed this episode. If so, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe and see you soon. Bye.